Hello and welcome to Andre's video blog for February 22nd, 2010. This is my first video blog for the new year, and the reason that was is because I planned to do one during the Christmas season, but we spent a lot of time during this previous December planning a trip to visit my aunt in Boonton, New Jersey, and that's where we stayed from Christmas Eve till the end of the weekend. And I actually used this Samsung camera to make a film of it. I don't normally use these video cameras to make these video blogs, primarily due to the fact that I had a little trouble using the YouTube link that came with the software to this camera. On the other hand, I got a little bit tired of the low quality of the webcam image I was using, so I decided to give this one a spin. And from now on, all my video blogs that I make will be made using this camera, since I've found a way to use the software more functionally. Anyhow, the movie I made in Boonton with my family actually reminded me of some of the aches and pains of using this kind of software. Now, it's not a negative thing. All that means is that, you know, it takes a little time to find the right digital studio software for my kind of computer. You know, there's always these issues of CPU, megahertz, and RAM capacity, and all these other things I really don't know anything about. So what I'm doing now is using my new software that came with this camera. Well, it's not new, but the software that came with this computer, and also using the software that came with my computer, which is Windows Movie Maker. Now, as you all know, Windows Movie Maker cannot accommodate MPEG 4 format without a codec, and working with those is just a pain in the neck, so I've been looking for a software that can do all the things that Windows Movie Maker can without the hassle of having to convert an MPEG 4 file to a Windows Media file, which with my software right now is really, really difficult. I recently tried Corel video software, which slowed down the computer and didn't really work, and I actually had to take it back, and that's where that's at. But I'm just wondering, a little question for all you YouTubers out there. If any of you watching this video can think of a video software that's compatible with MPEG 4 files, audio and visual, that can make videos with all the effects and transitions and so forth that you would get with Windows Movie Maker, and also be able to add different backgrounds to central moving objects and perhaps certain forms of 3D imagery without overloading an Acer Extensa computer, for example. I just don't let too many people know what I have. Please give me a ring. Or not only that, if you also know the codec that will enable Windows Movie Maker to function with MPEG 4 completely, audio and visual, and do the same things I could without the file conversion, please let me know how to work that. Leave comments or email me here at YouTube, and I appreciate all the information that you could possibly give me. It's a big world out there, and a lot of different people have tried it, and sometimes Amazon.com reviews or even product reviews elsewhere don't always help. It always helps to talk to people who may not use those and who may have advice on their own. So this is one little blog where I'm actually asking for a little help on something. So if any of you have any information, again, please leave your comments about codecs to make Windows Movie Maker compatible with MPEG 4, or a good digital studio software that won't overload the RAM or whatever of a desktop, laptop computer, I should say, a notebook. So thank you very much, and I hope that the new video blog will come sooner than this one did. So long for now.